Amtran to the Nuka World Transit Center will be leaving the park promptly at 11:55 p.m. Thank you.
Never been here.
Survivor at the Safari Adventure Replication Facility, continuing my personal recordings. I've been continuing to modify the Nuka Gen Replicator to provide a source of food. It's ironic that the very same device Nuka World was using to create its animal specimens for leisure has become integral to my survival. Using a tissue sample from a cow, I was able to replicate a viable clone, consume it as food, then use the remaining tissue to create another. I figure as long as the Nuka Gen Replicator continues to function, I'll have an endless supply of food for years to come. Dr. Hine would be proud of my accomplishment. It's sad. It's been so long, I've almost forgotten what he looked like. My God, it's been decades now. Maybe even a century or more, hasn't it? Has it been so long? I'll continue recording later. This is Dr. Darren McDermott, last known survivor at the Safari Adventure Replication Facility, continuing my personal recordings. It's been... hell, I don't know how long it's been. I think I stopped counting months ago. Or was it years? Even with the scientific equipment at my disposal, it's clear there's no going back from what I've become. The radiation from the bombs has taken its toll on my body, twisting and deforming my physical appearance. But instead of falling into despair, I've embraced the change and used it as a basis for my new cloning research. Perhaps this curse will turn out to be a blessing. I just wish Dr. Hine was here to guide my hand. I feel lost without him.
Thank you.
gracious Dr. Darren McDermott, last known survivor of the Safari Adventure Replication Facility, continuing my personal recordings. I ventured outside today and almost got spotted by a group of wasteland scavengers that had wandered into Safari Adventure. Therefore, against my own better judgment, I'm going to attempt to splice a few of the more dangerous samples I've left in cold storage. I need to use the NukaGen replicator to create some sort of specimen that's formidable, yet trainable. Something that can protect me, but most importantly, protect this facility. It will take some time to work out the chemistry and mathematics of the data, but I'm confident I can create a viable specimen within a few years. I know Dr. Hine would have objected to this course of action, but he isn't here, and I can't let this equipment fall into the wrong hands.